If you've read Elantris, you'll likely agree with me that of all three viewpoint characters, none were as well realized as Hrathen. In my opinion, Hrathen not only outshone the likes of Raiden or Serene, but just completely stole the show in general. Now, don't get me wrong, Raiden and Serene were both fun to read. Each had their fun and unique aspects that made their chapters a joy to read. But in terms of being the better character, they don't hold a candle to Hrathen. And the reason for this is simple. It's a small concept that took me a while to realize after working on my own writing. It's growth. Hrathen simply shows more of it than either of the other viewpoint characters have. Let's look at Raiden. Right from the beginning, he is thrust into the decaying city of fallen gods and has all odds stacked against him. He's lost his home, his comfort, his friends, and the whole life he's known before. By all rights, he should be angry. He should be morose and completely downtrodden. Heck, he should be at least a little sad. But he's not. Oh sure, he's not really happy about it, but he just kind of accepts it and goes on to try and make life livable in Elantris. Despite constant pain, dire circumstances, a bleak future, and regular failures, he never stops being the hopeful young prince with a determined smile and a lust for helping others. No growth, no change. He's the same man at the end as he was when he started. But let's not keep busting the chops of our good man Raiden, shall we? He's hardly the only character with this issue. Let's move right on to Serene. Serene is married off in a political betrothal to Raiden. She arrives and finds that her husband is dead and she's stuck living a chaste life as the widow of a man she's never going to meet. Her father-in-law is an insufferable misogynist and her future is, at best, filled with needlework and growing old alone in a very unstable kingdom. She has every right to be upset or unhappy. But just like Raiden, she takes this all in stride and never once undergoes any meaningful character growth to better her position or odds in life. She just kind of stays the same and solves all her problems anyway. Is that bad? Not necessarily. And you could make the argument that having both Raiden and Serene as static characters doesn't really detract from what they do, their personalities, or what they ultimately accomplish. But even though it isn't necessarily bad that they don't change, what is a problem for me is that I failed to care about them because of it. But I'm getting ahead of myself. We still have one more character of import to discuss, and that's our main man Hrathen. Hrathen comes to a new country with a goal. He must convert the local population to his religion, or his emperor will likely kill everyone. Not willing to stain his hands further with blood after a previous attempt at doing the same caused a bloody civil war, he sets out to accomplish this near impossible goal. He suffers setbacks and twists that cause him to fail and falter multiple times. But he doesn't give up. He's committed to furthering the cause of his church. And when he eventually is faced with the reality that the bloodshed he's been trying to avoid is inevitable, he suffers a genuine crisis of faith. He actually undergoes a profound change and in the end completely turns on his own people to save Raiden. Now, his motivations for doing that might not have necessarily been to actually save Raiden, but more to fight against what his religion was turning into and the bloodshed it was causing. He chooses to do what he believes is right instead of what his religion says he should do. This from a man who was one of the highest ranking officials in the Shu Dereth faith. Hrathen underwent genuine change, and not only that, he did it whilst actively working towards a goal, a combination that I've referred to in previous videos as pro-tagging. Let me explain. I use the term pro-tagging to refer to the ideal of a perfect protagonist, a proactive character that undergoes hardship and change to not only achieve their goals, but also be a more complete character because of it. Proactive action alone doesn't cut it. There has to be genuine and notable change as well. Only through this will you create a character that the reader will care about. Raiden and Serene have buckets full of proactivity, but undergo no change. The result is two characters that are fun to read, but are overshadowed by the one character we actually care about. The one that undergoes change as well as being proactive. Hrathen. Whenever a character is living up to this ideal, I call it pro-tagging. And Hrathen does this even though he's not necessarily the protagonist. He's very much the antagonist for 99% of the story, yet he embraces the ideal of pro-tagging through and through. Well, it is an ideal, not a designation. Even a side character can be found pro-tagging. But getting back to the point at hand, Brandon didn't write bad characters when he wrote Raiden and Serene. He merely put them both in the same book as a character that was written better. And unfortunately, this resulted in Rathan stealing the thunder from both. I haven't quite found the same problem in any other Sanderson books I've read, so it's quite forgivable in his debut novel. But I'd actually like to hear from everyone else. Do you think Rathan was better written than Raiden or Serene? Do you think he stole the show like I did? Let me know in the comments below. And if you enjoy this kind of video and the other videos that I do, please feel free to subscribe. I upload twice a week, and I intend on doing quite a couple of videos in the Cosmere and other fantasy books in general. I'd definitely like to have you tag along for the journey. But until next time, this has been Raven, and I'll see you again soon.